Well, the storm has strengthened a little bit over the last 24 hours. It has wind speeds sustained at 50 miles an hour. It's in the central Gulf of Mexico right now, so it's in the prime spot to get stronger and stronger. However, it is pulling in some dry air right now, and that's inhibiting the strengthening process. Also, the storm is very broad right now. There was actually an outer band that went through central Florida today and brought tornadoes to Orlando. So the storm system is very broad right now, and the circulation isn't super tightly packed, so it's not likely going to strengthen too much more as we go into the next couple of hours. Maybe up to 60 miles an hour, but it doesn't look likely it's going to get super big by the time it makes its way into southern Louisiana, likely tomorrow night, probably making landfall around 6 or 7 o'clock tomorrow night. The storm continues the path to the north, weakening as it moves over the Midwest. We don't have any severe weather across our area right now, but I am watching a couple of spots closely, especially the storm system that's moving into Isle of Wight County and eventually moving into Suffolk. This part of the storm cell here could contain 40 mile an hour wind gusts. It's just developed and it's looking a little bit healthier than other spots. Also pretty strong though across the bay too. We've seen some heavy rain so far from this. We have a flood advisory for this area highlighted in the light blue color here, including Gloucester Courthouse and Matthews County. Seeing about an inch to an inch and a half of rainfall. When I drew this box here, the radar estimates we've seen 1.4 inches of rain, but some of these brighter blue areas, there could be rainfall totals that are more than 2 inches. So you've seen some rainfall. We've had some high wind gusts. A lot of these little dots here indicate downed trees or some high wind gusts that are north of Reedville. We haven't seen a lot of severe weather reports or any big problems as they've been moving into the eastern shore or also the peninsula cities right now. It has been gusty and we are getting some heavy rain. We've already seen around 3/4 of an inch of rain in Williamsburg, so the rain is still coming down and we're going to get more. We need the rain, but it's coming down fast. Hampton, all across Hampton into Buckrow Beach, Pocosin, into Newport News as well, we have some heavy rain and this is making its path into the Southside cities. So there's two areas I'm watching, this zone here and this zone right here that's just to the north and east of Wakefield. This one, they're all moving at the same speed, about 25, 30 miles an hour. This one could create some gusts across Isle of Wight and in the city of Suffolk, around 40 miles an hour. This particular storm cell here could also create some higher wind gusts as well. Around 30 miles an hour is what I'm seeing at this point. Here's a time to arrival. Kempsville, once again, and cities around Kempsville, we can use this whole zone right here, is roughly around 11:45, so we're about 20 minutes away. For much of Virginia Beach, you're going to see some of this rain, but much earlier than that, though, throughout Norfolk, we're about 10 minutes or so away before we'll see the rain move into the area. For other spots like Suffolk and also into Chesapeake, we're about an hour away from that, so we still have another 40 minutes to an hour before it moves into the rest of the cities. That's the loop for the last 2 hours, the storm system moving down to the south and over us for the next couple of hours, but by 2 a.m., it looks like it fades away and gets out of here. Temperatures tomorrow will be cooler, lower 80s or upper 70s. We'll have a wind out of the north tomorrow at 5 to 10 miles an hour, so it'll be less humid for your Sunday. Monday, 79, Tuesday, 82, and Wednesday, it heats back up, back to 87 degrees.